Welcome to Gord Field in Detroit Rock, Michigan. Nice town, isn't it?
Well, by nice, you mean a town that would welcome you by cold cocking you in the head with a vacuum cleaner and stealing your luggage in the middle of a motel check-in and throwing you off the bridge into a polluted lake? Well, enjoying your morning walk to the stadium? Then yes, Grim, very nice town. Couldn't be lovelier.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Purple Mutant Eaters go up against the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
Welcome to MFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partner's Bricks and Bricks Jr. Hey, man, these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know, what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. Fermented anything really tastes good.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. And that's a catch for 3 yards. Second down and 7. In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, and he made a mistake there, throwing into tight coverage. The result is an interception. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
He's hit the 40, and then to first down from a great kick with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and 10. And that's a first down. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
No, I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Second down and 10. Nasty D lineman, he's still got his hands up for the deflection. Third down and 10. And he's boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
First and 10. The receiver makes a grab for 5 yards. Oh. Second down and five. Third down and nine. And the quarterback throws another pick. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3 grand, but my watch is a bit slow.
I'm gonna ruin your world. You understand me?
And it's first and 10. And they call a 14 dirty break. This play, and he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Yay.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 9.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
Third down and long. At this rate, the QB is going to have more in it. Oh, nice hit. And there is nothing in the rule book for that penalty. The ref appears to be cheating. He's just making shit up. Third down and 6. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps offside to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
Third down and the punter is warming up. That ball was almost intercepted. If they don't pick it up here, they are giving a gift to the defense. The runner pulls out a chainsaw. His cleats are... Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about... You've got to avoid those spikes or you'll be a mutant pincushion.
I was a chubby kid, Grim. My parents sent me to bat camp. My big brother told me as soon as you get there, first kid you see and no one will mess with you. So I get off the bus at the camp, some kid runs up to me and stabs me.
Thank you. first and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Hey, Grim, what if in a second?
Oh, it's a punishing hit. And it's first and 10. And that's another two.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
First and 10. Second down, very lot. Picks up maybe 2 yards. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game. Third down and 9. Oh, look at this guy break tackle. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? Conserve those runners now and consider passing more. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. Oh, with the brain scrambler. Second down and a lot. I've had it.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Second down and 9. The quarterback catches the ball and it rebounds back.
He can't get rid of it. It's like me and these crabs, Grim.
Yep, the defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick and the QB is in a heap of trouble now.
Back him.
Third down and, well, good luck. And they'll line up for the punt here. should move him back nicely. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. Stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and the offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. And it's first and 10.
Oh my gosh! The defensive player looks like he's lost!
He was starting to go some... Oh man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy! Gotta love it!
He should bite his head off for an encore!
Second down and 7. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... Yeah, never mind. Yes, Brick, he will.
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined.
And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Wow, the quarterback, he could go all the way. The 20. And quarterback. One in for the first down. And it's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10. And the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Second down in a very lot. Oh, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole.
Third down and long. At this point with multiple interceptions, pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10.
Is the game over yet? I gotta go to the vet to have him reattach my big toe to where my thumb was again. It just fell off for the third time today. I was barely even shooting.
Bricks, it's the 2-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
Second and 3. Well, he fumbled that one. Everyone loves being on the highlight reel, leaping over a defender, but sometimes you get hit hard and have the ball knocked loose.
Your game for time.
first down and one. He refuses to go down. And that's a run for no gain. And that'll bring up second and one. For their own offense. They're hungry for the ball, partner.
The ball? The pigskin? Bacon! I'm hungry for bacon!
The quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. The defense calls a second timeout. They really need to make a stop here. And they'll line up goal. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, you know what? Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Nah, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't know. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. 1 yard gain on that pass play.
Hey, look at the coach. He's picking his nose. You know, they shouldn't put that on the Jumbotron.
And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 76.
Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused!
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? We're gonna go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit.
I am a hell of a fellow.
home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Second down and more than the QB would like. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger because he's gonna kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message because the messenger killed him. I'm going in circles.
First and 10. And the defense gets another pick. Man, rough day.
Hey, Grim, what if interceptions counted as touchdowns? I'd be in the
hole. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
Hey, man, I was here on the panel now. You know what I mean?
First and 10. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. First and 10. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Boom! And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. First and 10. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps offside to kill him. First and 4. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Second down and 4. Does the QB know which team? Man, what a hit that was! Action. first and 10. Second down and long. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Oh, my God, a man from prison just came out of the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker.
Oh, man, he really wants it.
First and 10.
Welcome to McRoy Rage. How can I help you?
Yeah, I'll take it.
And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Second down and 10. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, he broke free and has open field in front of him. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, what a throw. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. And it's first and 10. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10. And I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really...
Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. First and 10. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah.
And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Whoa, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and 10.
time when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Second down and a lot. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Pow! With the brain scrambler! And it's first and ten. Caught for the first down. And it's first and ten. When defensive players go berserk, they've been... I'm running out of excuses for this QB. And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. He's at the 20. The 10. Oh, so close, but not today. First down and six. That's a 4-yard gain. Second and three. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And he just wrestles away from that tackle. And it's first and ten. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him.
My cellmate prison did a dance like this my first night in the big house. It was trouble then, and it's trouble now.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's first and ten. And with another pick, the QB... Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like... Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and ten. He's not going down. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. It's first and 10. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Second down and 10. And they're picking up chunks of yards now. Nice reception for 10 yards. And that'll bring up third down and inches. And he breaks away. He could go all the way. Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm. Their marketing team, hey!
And it's first and 10. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch!
And it's first and 10. Get your motor. He could go all the way. Chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuff burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
First and 10. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but Eddie sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. And watch his confidence.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And it's first and 10. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. You know, the league used to flag this for excessive celebration. You know, refs really don't want to get too close to the rabid roided out monsters. And don't even get me started on the werewolves. And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And it's first and ten. Time. Like a jack-in-the-box, Bricks. You never know when one of those hot potatoes is gonna blow. You just crap your pants, Junior. And it's first and ten. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
Dead in place on defense, schmuck.
Second down and ten.
Ah, another interception.
Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and ten. He just got crushed. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Second down in a very lot. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Third down, and the punter is warming up.
I personally think the ginormous guy is compensating for something, but I won't be the one to tell him.
This guy's a brick shithouse.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
No.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays! Talk about luck!
And it's first and ten. Put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast. And then catch will give them a first down. You knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Oh, Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Well, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through.
And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry up too?
Rip, can I kill him?
I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this cube. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's first and ten. Timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Down. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be caught
straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker.
Goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's Matt's stupsing time.
That's why the girls called me Speedy Guns.
Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
And that's a run for no gain. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. The offense is going to... They stop the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have mine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Play had no chance. This baby is over and the fat lady is singing.
Speaking of fat, once I decide to burn some calories, so I set a fat kid on fire.
Hey, I wonder if a fat drug dealer sells Diet Coke.
And he's off to the races.
No more timeouts for the defense.
Or the offense, Bricks. That's the important part. First down and nine. That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and nine.
Mr. Feet for Brace Man with a ball didn't fall down.
trying to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Oh, and that's how you play defense. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And the quarterback throws. Ooh, that hit's going to shave a few days off his life. The Maniacs rule today and take home a big win. After a stomping like that, the opposition may be a permanent part of the field.
More like a graveyard, Grim. There are body parts everywhere, and speaking of body parts, did I ever tell
you... Well, let's listen to MVP. I'm sure he has something inspiring to say. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so you...